this crayon too. That's Elmo's world. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Guess what Elmo's thinking about today? Yay! There, Mr. Noodle. You button your shirt. Mr. Noodle.
What about your tie?
Do your tie.
Watch out for your collars.
That looks good.
Very good, Mr. Noodle. What happened to his shirt?
It's sticking up.
That's okay, Mr. Noodle. Roll it down. Roll it down, Mr. Noodle. Oh, now put on your pants, Mr. Noodle.
You need pants, Mr. Noodle.
Yeah, your pants.
No.
On your leg. Not on your arms, Mr. Noodle.
Your pants go on your legs.
On your legs.
Yeah, on your leg.
No, only one leg at a time. You're doing it wrong. He looks like a penguin.
Put one leg in, then the other leg in.
That's it.
Oh, those are big pants.
Use the suspenders.
The suspenders will hold your pants up. You can do it. Yeah, Mr. Noodle.
Yay, Mr. Noodle.
He's all dressed.
Now you're all dressed. You look great, Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle.
He stuck to the door.
Be careful.
Mr. Noodle.
Boy, Mr. Noodle sure does have bouncy clothes. Was said, Dorothy? Oh, okay, okay. Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you get dressed?
Hi, Dorothy, this is how I put on my socks. First, you pull it up, then you pull it down. Now I do the other one. You pull it up again, and then you pull it down. And that's how you do it, Dorothy.
When it's cold, I put on my sweatshirt like this, Dorothy. First, I pull it over my head, then I put one arm through, and then I put the other arm through. See? Like that, Dorothy.
This is how you put on snow pants, Dorothy. First, you put one leg in. Then you put your other leg in. Then you tuck your shirt in. You snap it. Zipper it. Then you tighten it. That's how you put on snow pants, Dorothy.
Thanks, kids. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, Elmo is going to ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. How do you get dressed, baby? Here. Oh, thank you, baby. And now, Elmo has a question for you. Yes, you. How many pairs of pants are marching by? Let's count them and see.
Rubber Ducky wanted to tell you that he likes getting dressed sometimes. Mm-hmm. What's that, Rubber Ducky? Oh, okay. He's still getting dressed. Okay, Rubber Ducky. He's dressed now. He's dressed as a police officer. See his little blue police shirt and tie and his little police hat? Officer Ducky, you are a credit to your community. What's that, Officer Ducky? Oh, Officer Ducky says, let's quack this case. Oh, that Officer Ducky, he never misses a beat. Bye-bye, Elmo. Say goodbye.
Good night. Thanks, computer. Police officers wear blue shirts and ties when they get dressed for their jobs. That makes Elmo wonder, what do other people wear when they get dressed for their jobs? Elmo wants to know. Don't you? Let's find out. Draw a little help. A little help. What do firefighters wear when they get dressed to put out fires? A bathing suit?
No.
A tutu?
No.
A firefighter's uniform?
Yes.
To protect them.
Yeah. Gets dressed in a firefighter's uniform. What do astronauts wear when they get dressed to go into space? A scuba diving suit?
No.
A baseball uniform?
No.
A space suit?
Yes.
An astronaut gets dressed in a space suit. What do worms wear when they get dressed?
Worms don't get dressed.
Unless it's slimy and he can wear whatever he wants.
Looking good, Slimy.
Pretty scary. dressed all by herself. And then she helps her baby sister get dressed too. And she told Elmo all about it.
I'm 7 years old, and I can get dressed all by myself. It's easy. But my sister Ariana is a baby, and babies are too little to dress themselves. Sometimes I help Ariana get dressed. First, my dad changes Ariana's diapers. Babies wear diapers. Then I put on her t-shirt. Sometimes we play. Where is Ariana?
Where's Ariana?
There she is. We help Ariana put her arms through the sleeves. Then we put on her overalls. They have snaps.
They can be kind of tricky.
Babies have really little feet.
Ariana's favorite socks
have butterflies and numbers on them. Then we put on her shoes. There she is, dressed up and ready to go. Someday, Ariana will be old enough to get dressed all by herself. But until then, I'll be here to help her.
Nice job, Alexis! Now, Elmo wants to learn even more about getting dressed, don't you? How can we learn more? Yeah! We can watch the Getting Dressed channel. Hey, even TV got dressed today. Well, turn around and let us see you, TV. Oh, wow. TV looks very nice. Turn yourself on.
Welcome to the Getting Dressed channel.
We're a really great outfit. And now it's time for a song about getting dressed.
I love getting dressed. If you love getting dressed, then I got a song that'll knock your socks off. Come on, let's sing and get dressed. If you've already dressed, you can pretend to get dressed. I put my legs in my pants. I put my legs in my pants. You put your legs in your pants, you'll be doing a dance.
Next on the Getting Dressed channel, Socks and the City, followed by Shall We Pants, starring Shirt Reynolds.
Thank you, Stevie. Thank you. Oh, look. Elmo got dressed with the song. But Elmo still wants to learn more about getting dressed. How can Elmo find out more?
Why not look in a book?
Where's the book? Oh, yeah, can book tell Elmo more about getting dressed?
Sure. My title is The History of Getting Dressed.
Oh, boy. Open up and let's see what's inside, Book.
Okay. Back in cave person days, people got dressed in cave person clothes.
Wow, a dressed cave person.
Later in ancient Rome, people got dressed in togas.
Elmo dressed in a toga. Toga! 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 Toga!
In medieval times, people got dressed in clothes made of metal. They were called knights in shining armor. In Scotland, people got dressed in skirts called kilts. And they still do.
Buck knows a lot about getting dressed.
Well, I try to cover everything.
Elmo loves getting dressed. Oh, and so does Dorothy. That's why Dorothy wants us to sing the Getting Dressed song.
Hey, I love that song. May I join in?
Sure. Here we go.
Getting dressed, getting dressed, getting dressed.
Sing along if you want.
Bye, Book Again.
Bye.